To show you the history of the last 20 years, and you will be shocked at the record of constant warfare, a record that no medium but the screen can give you adequately. The World War means little to the youth of today, but perhaps after seeing this picture, it will mean almost as much to them as it does to those of us who lived through it. The younger generation may consider the great struggle unimportant, but they suffer its effects today. Thousands wonder why they find it hard to earn a living. These pictures are the answer. Pacifists may object to these scenes of constant warfare, but they picture only the facts of those years. Those who sincerely desire peace must see to it that the next 20 years are not like the last. 1914, 20 years ago, at 11:10 in the morning, on Tuesday, July 28th, on a hot summer day, Emperor Franz Joseph of Austria-Hungary declared war on Serbia. Kaiser Wilhelm supported him, mobilizing the great German military machine and hurling it into action.
Then Imperial Russia mobilized against the Central Powers, the Tsar's marching millions.
France joined Russia, beginning a conflict which spread until it involved 27 nations, including our own, and cost the lives of 8.5 million men.
1917, President Wilson signed the Declaration of War on April 6th. And America's manhood was drafted.
General Pershing went overseas, followed by 2 million men of the AEF, the troops that turned the tide, smashing the Hindenburg line and Germany's hope of victory.
Russia overthrew its Tsar, ending the 300-year reign of the Romanovs.
Then the Bolsheviks seized power and overthrew Kerensky, creating Europe's first modern dictator, Lenin the Red.
1918. The armistice was celebrated by the world after 4 years which affected our civilization.
But to Germany, the defeat meant revolution. The Reich went from Kaiser to chaos, Ebert becoming the first president, and the Kaiser went to Dorn, a warlord in exile.
1919. At Versailles, in the famous Hall of Mirrors, peace was dictated by the Big Four, Lloyd George, Orlando of Italy, Clemenceau, and Wilson.
Faced by international greed and rivalry, they strove to reconcile idealism and selfishness, remaking the map of Europe.
Ancient nations came to life and new countries were carved out of the two great empires. In their place, there sprang up a host of buffer states created to ensure peace.
But they are now the very spots in Europe where war is most likely to break out.
The Sinn Féin troubles resulted in the Anglo-Irish War, which raged 2 years, full of bloodshed until the Irish Free State was formed.
Fiume was seized by D'Annunzio, who held it for Italy, almost starting another European war.
1920. Prohibition, the result of a wartime law to conserve grain, went into effect, ushering in a lawless era of bootlegging and gangster rule.
The League of Nations was organized by 13 nations at Geneva and had 42 members at its first session.
1921, the Rift Revolt, flaring in Africa against France and Spain, challenged European rule by wiping out a Spanish army.
President Harding inaugurated the Naval Arms Conference at Washington, where we gave up battleships and the other powers gave up blueprints.
1922, the so-called Heron Massacre in Illinois emphasized unrest in America, which resulted in useless violence.
In Italy, Mussolini and his black shirts marched on Rome to end unrest there, the rise of fascism and Il Duce.
1923, France determined to make Germany pay for the World War.
She occupied the Ruhr to force payment of reparation.
1924, General Dawes evolved a plan for German reparations which was administered by Owen D. Young, the first of many plans for payment that Germany failed to fulfill.
Greece, where popular outbreaks resulted in ousting King George II, voted to become a republic and stayed that way.
1926, Great Britain's general strike, the result of a post-war depression, threatened the stability of the government.
The walkout involved 2.5 million workers.
1927, Our Marines went down to Nicaragua to protect American interests during the Civil War there, an occupation that lasted 6 years.
Then Civil War in China flared up. Thousands died daily on the battlefield, and an anti-foreign drive threatened Europeans. Many were killed.
1928, President Coolidge opened the Pan-American Conference for peace.
But revolutions continue.
1929, a new revolt broke out in Mexico, led by General Escobar.
4,000 were killed before the rebellion ended.
The Wall Street stock crash directly affected 25 million people and caused losses of $50 billion, the result of the wartime speculation craze.
Hoover announced the Kellog-Briand anti-war treaty in which 62 nations pledged themselves to renounce war.
1930, Argentina immediately staged her own domestic war.
Dictator Irigoyen was forced out of office.
1931, Japan invaded Manchuria and took the country.
Defying the world to find an outlet for expansion, even if she had to fight for it.
She created Manchukuo, an empire under Kang Te, former boy emperor of China.
But in Europe, monarchy fell. Turbulent Spain ended the rule of the Bourbons and exiled her popular King Alfonso, the unlucky 13th, becoming a republic under President Zamora.
1932. Across the world in Shanghai, the Japanese, still fighting for a place in the sun, shelled a native quarter, killing thousands in a ruthless attack.
In India, Gandhi stirred millions to passive resistance against British rule, another evidence of Asiatic resentment against European domination.
The so-called bonus army, which had gathered in Washington to demand cash from the government, clashed with the authorities and refused to leave.
When the police proved unable to handle the rioters, the regular army routed them in a street battle in the shadow of the Capitol.
1933, Roosevelt became our 32nd president and the New Deal went into action against the post-war depression.
With the CWA and CCC, the NRA put 4 million men back to work. The Blue Eagle attempted to secure fair play in all industries, speeding America on the road to recovery.
Prohibition ended, causing the downfall of the bootleg kings and pouring millions into Uncle Sam's treasury.
MacDonald of England, Hull of America, Bennett of Canada, and Herriot of France discussed trade and war debts.
But England and France defaulted just the same.
Russia was recognized through Litvinov, ending for the time a dangerous crisis in the Far East, where Japan challenged the world.
Hitler became Chancellor of Germany, succeeding von Schleicher, recently shot by the Nazis. The brown shirts rose to power by promising to end the Versailles Treaty and rearm.
Cuba revolted, ousting Machado amid scenes of turmoil and bloodshed which turned Havana into a shambles.
1934. Today, the eyes of America are on our own labor troubles, like the San Francisco general strike.
Here is industrial strife, which is war worse than the World War. A war of neighbor against neighbor.
Brother against brother.
American against American.
Such scenes as these at Ambridge, Pennsylvania during the strike there have no place in America.
And scenes like this during the New York taxi strike indicate a spirit of lawlessness and disregard of the rights of others that cannot be tolerated.
Abroad, labor troubles and political turmoil are greater than in 1914. In France, recurring riots like this have threatened the Republic.
In Austria, Europe's most important buffer state, Red Vienna was stormed by government troops to crush a socialist revolt.
In Germany, the Nazis retain power by what they call a purge of blood. But underneath the outward calm is a rising tide of restlessness.
Germany wants to triple her army, and the world is more of an armed camp today than in 1914.
Red Russia has modernized her troops, while communists abroad preach pacifism.
And France greeted Bastille Day with bayonets to uphold her conception of liberty, equality, fraternity.
On the high seas, Great Britain increases her navy, preparing to meet Japan's demand for parity in 1935. While America is building our fleet to treaty strength.
Throughout the world, there is a feeling of insecurity surpassing that on the eve of the World War.
World peace lies in the hands of a few men. In Europe, it is the day of dictators like Hitler,
Mussolini,
and Stalin.
In Asia, it is the day of empire under Japan's Mikado.
And in America alone lies the hope of democracy.